Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com, and in this epic tutorial series, I will teach you all about in-app purchases in Xcode 10 with Swift 4.2 and in iOS 12. You will learn about in-app purchases like auto-renewable subscriptions, non-consumable subscriptions, and of course, consumables and non-consumables, and much, much more, how to handle all of this in your code and in the App Store Connect dashboard. So without further ado, let's get started. Great. Now, let me just show you what we are going to build out today. And for that, I will show you the final project that I have created here. And please do know that we need to have a real device to test out in-app purchases, because you could test out some features of in-app purchases on the simulator, but purchasing can be done only on a real device. Okay. So let me just show you my device here, and let's just build and run this final project. Okay, let's select our phone here and let's build and run. Okay, here we go. And we are in. Okay, this is pretty good. But before I go into the details, let me show you, because this will occur for multiple times in your development lifecycle, how to get rid of all of the cached data. So what you need to do first is stop your project from running. And let me just show you here. Simply delete your app from your device or from the simulator. Okay, let's click on done here and off it goes. Next up, if you are using Rebeloper Store Pro, because in just a minute I will show you and discuss you about what's the difference between Rebeloper Store Basic and Rebeloper Store Pro, just go ahead and go into Rebeloper Store Setup and under Reset Keychain to Default Values, set this to True. Okay, I will go into these details just in a few videos from now. Okay, next up, what you want to do is go under Product and select Clean Build Folder. Okay, and now that the clean has been done, again, build and run. Okay, let us just wait for that. And build has succeeded. Let me just simply stop that again, so I may remove the place of my app to the front screen, so you don't see any new projects coming up. So I will simply build and run again. So here you go. There is our Rebeloper Store and build. And now you will get a brand new build of your project. And now let us just go through what we have here. First of all, and do take a look at the log when any action is performed in the app, so you may see how Rebeloper Store logs your actions. Okay, first of all, we have a consumables screen, and we are going to start this tutorial off with this screen. And as you saw earlier, the bag of coins and the chest of coins have been fetched from App Store Connect. All the information is displayed in this nice UI collection view. Next up, and of course, we have our 1000 coins added on the first launch of our app. And this little red arrow at the top right corner of our screen is the Restore Purchases button. Okay, let's go to our non-consumables. Now, non-consumables are like the no ads, non-consumable in-app purchase, or let's say unlock a new level. As you can see, here we have a banner, a go to next level button, and the two in-app purchases. Let's go further. Here we have our auto-renewable subscriptions. Now, we have set up two groups, one for drink coffee and the other one is eat donuts. Okay, for now we are not subscribed for that, and we have free in-app purchases for drink coffee, a weekly, a monthly, and a quarterly, and one for eat donuts, and that is for a weekly subscription. Okay, let's go even further. We have our non-renewable subscriptions, and here we have only a drink coffee subscription. Okay, let's go even further, and this is where the real magic happens. Let me just show you what this last tab bar means. And as you can see, we have virtual goods and a secondary virtual currency. Let's select virtual goods. Okay, now you can see that we have 1000 coins, 50 gems, 10 bombs, 0 swords, and 0 helmets. Okay, and of course we have our use bomb button, because that is a virtual good that is consumable. Great. And below you can see the free virtual goods. One is the sword that can be bought with coins. This is a virtual non-consumable, because you just buy it and use it, and you buy it for coins. Let's jump right down to the helmet, which is again another virtual good that is non-consumable, but this time you buy it with 80 gems. So not just coins, you buy it with the secondary virtual currency. Now let's talk about the bombs. Now the bombs are a consumable type of virtual good. And of course you can buy it at this time with 150 coins. You could buy it with gems too. So that is it for our app. Let me just go. Oh, I just forgot. How do you buy secondary virtual currency? The gems. Well, it is pretty simple. Let's go to secondary virtual currency, and here we have our stats for the currencies, and then we have an option, well, two options to buy secondary virtual currencies: bag of gems and chest of gems. Of course, you buy gems, the secondary virtual currency, with the first, well, primary virtual currency, with coins. And that is how easy it is to have virtual goods, virtual currencies. That is really important for modern, let's say, free-to-play games in your portfolio. Okay, that is it for the walkthrough of our app that we are going to build. Now let's take a closer look at the project. So, as you can see, I have created a starter project. So, where can you download this starter project? Well, go ahead and click the link down below, and you will be taken to all of the resources needed. Okay, and let's just talk about a few how this project is set up. Okay, first of all, let me just show you where you will be taken with the link to my starter project, so you will be able to download it, and we will do that in the next video. But for now, let me just show you the GitHub repository. So here it is, Rebeloper Store Starter, and you will be taken with the link to this project. Okay, you can clone it or download it. We will clone it in the next tutorial. Now let's take a look at some helper repositories that really make up the good stuff that Rebeloper Store has to offer. And for that, I will go back to my Xcode here, and let's take a look at the pod file, and I will just minimize this lock here. Of course, the platform is iOS 12, and we are looking right now at the pod file, and we are using Merchant Kit. Now, Merchant Kit is a really, really good alternative to the others out there, because it's a brand new approach of using the StoreKit framework, and let me just show you where that is. Of course, all of these will be linked in the resources. So it is about from Benjamin Mayo, if I spell that out correctly, and you can take a look at how a merchant kit works, but you really don't have to, because Rebeloper Store takes care of simplifying all of the actions. Now, let me just go back to my Xcode project here, and you can see that here we have both for Rebeloper Store Basic, and for the Rebeloper Store Basic, that's basically it. So you don't need Keychain Suite or Bulletin Board. That is because Rebeloper Store Basic supports only the consumables. So if you want to have non-consumables, auto-renewable subscriptions, non-renewable subscriptions, and the whole virtual goods and currency stuff, then you need to upgrade to Rebeloper Store Pro. But I will talk about that in just a few lessons. For now, do know that Keychain Swift and Bulletin Board are needed only for Rebeloper Store Pro. Now, you can see that I have posts for our example project too, because all of these UI collection views and all of these views inside them need to be handled by some pro good GitHub repositories, and I have chosen collection kit and tiny constraints, and let me just show you there. So here is Keychain Swift, here is a bulletin board if you want to take a look at it, and here we have collection kit that handles UI collection view controllers, and it is so sweet. I will create separate videos on this. And tiny constraints that handles anchoring and positioning views inside our app. And I will most probably create new videos on tiny constraints too. So let's get back into our Xcode. And as you can see, we have some version limitations. And that is because I want to make sure that the pod that you install works correctly. Of course, I will periodically update to the newest version of Merchant Kit and the other pod files too. Now, I hope you are really excited about the new ways of creating in-app purchases into your apps, and hope you are eager to find out more about Rebeloper Store and the Rebeloper Store Starter project. So, in the next video, we are going to do just that. We are going to download Rebeloper Store Starter project, and we are going to get working on in-app purchases. Now, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, go ahead and give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. And I dare you to hit that notification bell to get notified when new uploads of this awesome in-app purchases tutorial series will be updated with new videos. So without further ado, let's get into the next video. So I will see you in the next one.